Assalamu alaikum friends, how are you? Hopefully all of you are fine. My name is Engineer Muhammad Wasim, and today is the lecture that I am recording is the lecture number 20. In the today lecture, I will discuss in front of you a different antenna known as a zipline antenna. Now before going toward the topic, it is requested to all of you that kindly subscribe my channel Infotech Science and also press bell icon so that we can connect with each other, and whenever I upload my new video you can get through notification. Now moving toward the topic, the topic is a zipline antenna. Friends and the students, in 1950 an airship is actually designed, and this airship name as a zipline aircraft or airships. This type of airship have the shape like that of, you can say that, a horizontal shape. Therefore, according to their shape, this antenna named as a zipline antenna. Usually, the zipline antenna are existed in a horizontal shape. You can say that in a horizontal line shape. And this antenna have a multiple half wavelength length long. Usually, many type of the antennas are usually fed at the center points. But this type of antenna is usually fed at the end point like that. This is actually the antenna with the having the name of the zipline antenna. This antenna, you can easily saw that this antenna have a feeding point at the end section and the radiating element is on the other side. Both the parts are connected here, and this antenna is usually looking as a horizontal antenna. Now what are the benefit for connecting the, you can say that, the feed line at the end point neither than connecting in the center points like in a dipole antenna? The main benefit is that by connecting the feed line at the end point is that it has a very high input impedance as compared to the if we connect the connector at the center point. Now this type of antenna is usually have main two benefits. One benefit is that it has a very high current at the center point, as you saw in the diagram in the video, and very low current at the end section. However, the voltage at the end section is maximum and center is a minimum voltage. Now this type of antenna is usually, you saw that this type of antenna is usually used in a very high frequency or ultra high frequency, or you can also saw this type of antenna in the FM receiver section. If you saw this type of antenna known as a zipline antenna, as its shape is look like of the J, you can easily saw that its shape is like a J type. Sometimes they called also as a J type antenna. Now how it is designed, this J type antenna? Actually this antenna has a three parts. One parts is actually a 50 ohm feed line, that is a coaxial cable which is connected at this point. And second part is actually its you can say that the matching part, which is lambda by 4, and third is actually a radiating element which is having the length of the lambda by 2 or half wavelength. Friends, now moving toward the practical design of the J type antenna. This is actually a J type antenna with having a divided into the three different portion, or you can say that it is divided into the three different length. The length is L1, L2 and L3. Now if you saw that, this is actually the stainless steel body, or you can say that the copper pipe which is inserted here, and this portion, this is upward portion on which I move my finger, is the length L1. This L1 have actually a lambda by 2. This lambda by 2 is actually a radiating element through which the electromagnetic waves radiate from this portion. This is actually known as L1. Now the second part is the L2, which is the matching part. The matching part is actually the middle part that can connect the radiating part with the feed line part. Now you can easily saw that this is the transmission line. This is transmission line is actually the length L2 with having the wavelength of lambda by 4. This lambda by 4 is actually, you can say that, the matching structure or the matching antenna for connecting between the radiating element with the feed land, and the length L3 is actually the feeding distance between the matching part and the coaxial cable connection, which is not, you can see that, but it is this part where the connector is connected with this, you can say that this transmission line. Now there are three parts or three type of length: L1, L2, and L3. The length L1 is the resonating length, length L2 is the matching length, and the length L3 is actually the distance from shore to the feed points. Now this pipe is usually made up of the, you can say that, the stainless steel or the copper hollow pipe. This is specially used for the radiating, as a radiating element. Now the main application is that its application is used in FM, also used in ultra high frequency band, for very high frequency band, as its shape is just like, you can say that, as a J shape. Therefore sometime it is called as a J type antenna, sometime it is called as a horizontal antenna, sometime it is also called as a zipline antenna because of its relevance with the zipline aircraft shape in the late 50s. And its radiation pattern is you can saw that have a two lobes, one in the upward direction and one in downward direction, with a minor lobes, or you can say that the side lobe in every direction, in both the directions. Now this is the today topic in which we discuss what is the zipline antenna, how it is designed. The antenna look as this is actually the antenna having a connectors connected with a matching transmission line, this, and this matching transmission line is connected with the radiating element. Hopefully you can understand. And at the end, if you like the video, press like, and now I am leaving. Bye. Thanks for watching the whole video.